In this video, we will talk about what happens when you're trying to solve integration by parts problems that involve definite integrals. So everything we've done so far has been indefinite integrals for all these integration by parts problems. But what happens if you have limits on these integrals if they are definite integrals? Well, the idea is still the same. You just have to deal with the limits at every step. And what I mean by that is when you do the integration by parts, you will have limits that show up on the functions as evaluations at the two endpoints. And then you will have the limits that show up on the second integral as well. Something like this: the integral from a to b of u dv is equal to uv evaluated at a and b minus the integral from a to b of v du. So in essence, this simplifies out to here being u at b times v at b minus u at a times v at a, and then minus this integral term over here, like normal. So you just have to deal with the limits on this function term as well as on the integral at the end. A second way to deal with these problems is to forget the limits entirely, solve the whole problem as an indefinite integral, and then plug in the limits at the end. That is the fundamental theorem of calculus applied to this problem. You can also ignore the limits, do the problem like an indefinite integral, and then plug in limits at the end. Both ways here will get you the same answer at the end of the problem. So here's an example. Compute the integral from 2 to 5 of t ln of t dt. It's a product, so let's try integration by parts. And what do our rules say here? Well, our guidelines for picking u and v here say we should differentiate the ln term because we have no way to integrate that at this point. So I should pick u to be log of t, and dv should be t dt. Now, in this case, we're integrating a polynomial, but that's okay because the rule that was first on the list was differentiate logs, and then it became differentiate polynomials. It turns out here this will actually get us to a solution for this problem. So we can now fill in the table. V is t squared over 2, and du is 1 over t dt. And now let's do the integration. So integral from 2 to 5 of t log of t dt should be u times v, so t squared over 2 times log of t from 2 to 5, and then minus the integral of v du, also from 2 to 5. Simplifying this out, I get a t squared over 2 log of t from 2 to 5 minus a 1 half integral from 2 to 5 of t dt, because the t squared and the t can't, one of those cancels out. I can integrate that last term now. That's an easy one to integrate. T squared over 2 log of t from 2 to 5 minus t squared over 4, also from 2 to 5. And now you can see why you could also do limits at the end, right? I have the limit part on every single term, so I could do it at every step, or I could just wait till the very end to deal with all my limits. And now let's deal with all of our limits. So I get a 25 over 2 log of 5 minus a 4 over 2 log of 2 minus a 25 over 4 minus 4 over 4, 25 over 2 log of 5 minus 2 log of 2, and then minus 21 over 4. There's what you get for solving definite integral problems integration by parts. The ideas are still the same, the tricks are all the same, the rules are all the same. You just have to make sure you remember the limits and deal with them as you either as you go through the problem or at the very end once you're done to plug in your two endpoints and get your answer. Remember, it's a definite integral, so you don't need a plus c on these problems as well. So definite integrals work the exact same way with integration by parts. You have to make sure you keep track of everything so you get the right answer when you're done with the problem.